In this short tip, I will show you guys how to create this colorful triangle background in Adobe Illustrator. With this method, you guys can create this type of backgrounds very easily and very fast. All right, guys, first thing what I'm going to do is I'm going into the tools, and in here in the basic shapes, I'm going to select the polygon. Okay, so once you select the polygon, click on your artboard, which will bring up the polygon parameters. And for the radius, I'm going to select 500 is fine. And for the side, I'm going to select 6. All right, and just say okay, which will create this polygon in here. So we have 6 sides of these polygons. First, deselect the polygon and now go in and select the pen tool. Now we are going to draw lines connecting these anchor points, which are opposite to each other. All right, so I'm going to start from here, one in here, and the next one is this one. All right, so make sure you guys, you can click outside and delete. Make sure you guys go into view and activate the smart guides. And also make sure you have selected the snap to points option in here. So we can easily select these anchor points when we bring the mouse on top, all right? Again, second one, I'm going to select from here to here, all right? And the third one, I'm going to select from here to here. Okay, so now if you select all of these objects, you can see we have connected all these anchor points opposite to each other, all right? Now select all of them, make sure you don't have any fill, okay? And go into Pathfinder and select the divide from the Pathfinder in here, all right? So once you divide them, we have individual objects. So now select these and right click and ungroup them. Now, if you see, we have each of these as individual shape. Okay, so now I'm going to select some colors for each of these shapes. I'm just going to select some colors from my swatches. Later, we can change these colors, all right? So I'm just going to select this one and I'm going to apply this red color. And for this yellow. And for this green. And blue. Last one is this one. All right, so now we have each of these triangles with different colors. So all we need to do is select these and go to objects, and in here go to the repeat, this one, and select the grid repeat, which will place these polygons like this in here. All right, now go to the properties window and select the third one, this one in here, brick by column. So it will place this rectangle like this, brick style columns like this. And for this vertical gap, I'm going to say like 0. And for the horizontal gaps, I'm going to say -250, because we have this space half the size of this rectangle, which is 500. Okay, so I'm just going to select -250, enter. All right, so now we have our shape in here. Now you can bring it to your artwork. Let's say this is the background. You guys can adjust the size. All right, and now you can simply select this and go to object and expand the object. So we don't need to select the fill for this. We can just simply select the object, which is the grid, and we just select okay. Now our grid has been changed to regular vector objects. Now you can select these individually and apply colors. Okay, so I'm just going to apply the colors which I already choose from here. You guys can have any color you want. You guys can also apply gradients like I do from here. I already predefined the colors earlier, and you guys can have any colors you want. All right, guys, so finally our results is something like this in here. All right, guys, thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.